Hi, this is Sahil Kochhar, and I'm here to talk about how art has influenced me as an individual, the way it has shaped my aesthetics over the years. I believe art has been an integral part of the design process at Sahil Kochhar, and I really want to thank the Kiran Nadar Museum of Art for providing me with this opportunity to talk about art and fashion and what they mean to me. As a kid, I literally had no exposure to art, but I remember back in school, the first thing that I ever designed for myself was my school uniform, and thereafter I knew I have to be associated with a creative field, be it related to design or fashion. And as luck would have it, for my formal design education, I got through NIFT Gandhinagar, where I was given this opportunity to be taught by professors who had themselves studied at one of the historically most well-known art schools of India, the MSU Baroda. I remember them telling me stories and their first-hand experiences about the modern art movement within India. This really gave me a deeper understanding of this subject, and I learned a lot more about the evolution of art and how one can get inspired by it and use it for any creative or design process. Right after my graduation, I started working with Rohit Bal, who we are all aware is a pioneer in Indian fashion. Working closely with him on collections gave me a much wider and a practical knowledge of how one can translate art into fashion, which further helped me hone my sense of aesthetics. So eventually, when I decided to launch my own label, which was almost 6 years back in 2014, is when I started working on my first ever collection. So all this knowledge that I had garnered and gained over the years had to come together to ensure that the first collection that we come out with has to be unique and special. There were a lot of inspirations that I was going through, but this one fine day, I happened to be in the craft museum in Delhi, where I stumbled upon this craft called Shola Pith from West Bengal. I remember seeing an artisan there who was working with the pith of Shola plant, where he was carving out thin strips and shapes out of it, which he then put together and layered one on top of the other to create an image of an Indian goddess. The moment I saw that, I knew this is what our theme is going to be for the first collection. The collection was titled Phuler Tora, which literally translates to a bouquet of flowers in Bengali. This was our ode to the Shola Pith Malakars of West Bengal. That applique is going to be an important part of the brand's identity, and we wanted to develop on it and make this a signature. Over the years, we have had many inspirations for our collections, and I categorically remember this collection titled Chitra, where we were inspired by the bold and graphical artworks of Ayumi Takahashi. Her strong and powerful representation of women in her artworks was something that even we tried to incorporate in our collection. Another collection that I remember, titled Sangamarmar, was inspired by the marble inlay craft, which is also known as Pietra Dura. And one of the finest examples of it in India being the Taj Mahal itself. For this collection, what we had done was that we had developed marble textures on fabric, which were then meticulously cut into inlay shapes and appliqued onto a different fabric. this was our own interpretation of the ancient craft. Going forward, it was a natural progression of the brand to launch its debut couture collection. And we felt there was nothing better than revisiting the Sholapit craft and give it a new face and dimension which would be apt for the Indian bridal market. At this point, we had full clarity in respect to the embroideries and surfaces that we wanted to do. But we were still looking for an inspiration to give a new look to this genre. And that is when I got reminded of the works of Raja Ravi Verma, which almost had like a Renaissance-like treatment and finesse, but the subjects were still very Indian. And this is the same philosophy that I wanted to incorporate in my collection, where the garments were essentially Indian, but they had a global and modern appeal. This is when I realized that when you take inspiration from art, you know, it doesn't necessarily have to be a direct visual interpretation of the same. You can always get inspired by the philosophy and the concept behind the artwork. And while working on this collection, there were certain artists and art forms which had a great impact on my aesthetics. Artists like Edgar Degas, Botticelli, James Sand, Henry Russo, and this Iranian art form, Gulomurg. I took elements from all of them and incorporated into my collection. As I had mentioned, this was our debut couture collection, and I was certain that I want to represent it in a larger than life grand manner, an experience that people would cherish for a lifetime. And while working on the set design of the same, I had the works of Anish Kapoor and Subodh Gupta running in back of my mind. Like them, I wanted to use something that was everyday and mundane, but give it a treatment that would make it look larger than life. I remember we had ended up using red paper flowers, and almost 300,000 of those were used to cover up approximately a space of 60,000 square feet. It gave a visual representation of a red sea of flowers. And even now, if I look back at it, I feel really proud. Society. It is very representative of the era that it was created in, but at the same time, it has a timeless quality, which makes it relevant even centuries after it was made. I want my clothes to have the same timeless quality, elevating the status of a wardrobe to that of a museum. One that houses artworks created by artists for whom the canvas is their clothes. We recently launched our first flagship store. And while working on it, I was certain that I wanted it to be a reflection of my design sensibilities and values. So we decided to take forward one of our artworks and embroideries and convert it into installation that would be durable and functional. The original embroidery was inspired by the jungle landscapes of Henri Rousseau. But instead of using it as an embroidery, we decided to make it in brass, keeping the three-dimensional multi-layered quality of it intact, where brass was cut into shapes of leaves, petals, flowers, and jungle foliage, and then put together, layered one on top of the other to bring the jungle landscape to life. The brass installation is my favorite feature of the flagship store because it brings the cycle full circle, where at first I got inspired by art and created my own embroideries, and in turn, the embroidery became the inspiration for this brass installation. Blurring the lines between art and fashion. That's exactly where I want my brand's legacy to exist.